Mungu ni mwema.
Kila wakati.
Na kila wakati.
Mungu ni mwema.
Karibuni sana kwenye tafakari ya neno hili la Mwenyezi Mungu. Whereby we are hearing the first reading, Paul is happy. And he is grateful to God for giving him a chance and an opportunity to preach and to break his word to the nations. And we too, my dear brothers and sisters, we have an opportunity to serve one another, to serve the humanity. God has given us that very own chance that doesn't have many people. Let us use it and be grateful to God for the people that God will place under our care. The gospel reading, we are hearing Jesus commending a dishonest steward. And this dishonest steward is shrewd enough, or he is prudent enough, to recognize and to notice that his role is being taken away from him. But his prudence is asking him to look for a safer landing. You know, to look for a safer landing. And Jesus recommends him because he is looking for his place here on earth. But the encouragement, my dear brothers and sisters, is to be shrewd and to be prudent enough to look for the things that are above. To look for the things that are above. You can imagine if this dishonest steward, after the master got to know what was happening, what if he just went down to his knees and apologized, instead of plotting what he will do after this is taken away from him. And the master here represents Jesus. The master represents Jesus. We are all stewards in one way or another of the many gifts that God has given us. And sometimes we misuse them. Sometimes we become like this shrewd steward. Sometimes we are very, very much cunning and trying to look for all sources where we can manipulate and use our gifts wrongly. Jesus wants us to be accountable to the things that he has given us, to the gifts that he has given us, to the work that he has given us, knowing that we are answerable at least to somebody. But my dear brothers and sisters, instead of plotting how to find favor with the people and plotting how to find to be received and to be accepted in the community, it is very important to also introspect in ourselves and ask ourselves, what would God say about the services that I have rendered to humanity? Which place will God keep me? He realizes that he is not strong enough to dig, and he is ashamed to beg. The same way, if God was to assert his punishment upon us, my dear brothers and sisters, none of us would stand. None of us would be strong enough to carry out the judgment, the punishment. And none of us would receive anything even if we beg. So let us know that the owner of the resources that we use, the owner of the gifts that we all have, the owner of everything that he has given us, we shall give an account of it. How I pray that when we are put on the balance, our scale will be good enough to make us stand before him. And if, my dear brothers and sisters, we notice ways when we falter, let us not try to please men. Let us not try to bow down in the level of men. But let us always find a ground to approach the master. Let us be apologetic enough. Let the word sorry always be on our lips. Because we will never be perfect enough. From time to time we will falter. But the most important is, what will the master say about us? Am I reconciling myself with the master, or I am finding a safer ground, a temporary ground with the humanity? Let us try to please the master. And as we please the master, as we do what the master wants, then the humanity will be served. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.